Ron DeSantis is widely seen as somebody who is definitely running for president, especially because he's been out there the last couple of days traveling the country giving speeches, which isn't exactly something you're going to do if you're just going to sit and be governor for another 2 years or 4 years. So it's pretty obvious the man is running for president. And a lot of big money Republican donors want him to because they see he has the same policies as Trump without all of the horrible, possibly criminal baggage. But suddenly, a lot of those donors, a lot of those potential allies are now starting to express their concern about Ron DeSantis's little authoritarian power grab that's taking place down here in the state of Florida. It's not just about the banning of CRT, they're totally cool with that. It's the attempt to usurp all of this power within the state and consolidate it into DeSantis's office. It started, of course, recently with Ron DeSantis now being in charge of the special district where Walt Disney World sits. Now, DeSantis isn't gonna run it, of course, that would be ridiculous. It's gonna be run by several individuals who are going to be hand-picked by Ron DeSantis. So he gets to pick the people that are gonna run it, and if they do not run it the way he wants them to, he will simply remove them and place them with somebody who will run it the way he wants it run. So yes, he did grab up the power of that district. He recently went to war with New College, installed all these right-wing idiots onto the board, effectively destroying what that college once was. He's gone to war with AP classes and threatened to do away with AP classes here in the state of Florida, even though just a couple years ago, he said that those are great tools. He was a top AP student when he went to school, and now he wants to take it away because he's arguing with them over CRT. The state legislature down here in Florida is considering a piece of legislation that would consolidate the state's athletic board power and give it all to Ron DeSantis instead of the actual athletics board. So he, Ron DeSantis, would be in charge overseeing all athletics here in the state of Florida. He would get to say what they can do, what they cannot do, whether or not we have to test female athletes and find out when the last date of their menstrual cycle was. All of this is power consolidation under Ron DeSantis in the name of fighting wokeness. And the donors, the allies, they are starting to freak the hell out about it because, as they say, Republicans, we're supposed to be the free market people. We can't be interfering with corporations. We're supposed to be the small government people. We can't be consolidating all of this power into one person. Here's what they say. This is Chris Sununu, who is also a likely 2024 Republican contender. I'm a principled free market conservative. For others out there that think that the government should be penalizing your business because they disagree with you politically, that isn't very conservative. The group, the Foundation for Individual Rights and Expression, their legal director said, quote, "You cannot censor your way to freedom of expression. You cannot trade one orthodoxy for another. What we've seen recently in Florida is a troubling willingness to do just that." And the list goes on and on. CNN actually put together a brilliant and very long article explaining all of these things that Ron DeSantis has done and will possibly do, and all of the individuals and groups that are saying, hey, whoa, we're supposed to be conservatives. You're acting more like a little dictator, which is exactly what is happening. So in his effort to appeal to the Republican base in order to win a Republican primary, Ron DeSantis might be going too extreme and pissing off any moderate voter, moderate Republican voter that might have considered voting for him for president. And if he continues this, the entire country will eventually view this man as the little dictator, and he'll have no chance of winning another election ever again. That's not a bad thing either.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.